I'm going to show you how we can use switches like this one to control a communication device that is accessible with switches. So the app that I happen to have here is Tobii Dynavox Snap, but there are several other switch accessible apps that are going to work fairly similarly. So the first thing that we need to do is connect this switch to my communication device, which I've already done. Then I need to go into the settings of my communication app and change it so that it has an access method for switching. So default is always set to touch, and I'm going to change it to scanning so I can use some switches. And you see when I did that, it opened up this whole menu for switch scanning. So I can change the behavior of what this one switch does, or I can even add a second switch, and we'll look at that in a minute. But I can speed it up and slow it down and customize it so it's really fast and accurate for someone to be able to use switches to control this communication device. So I'm going to start with one switch auto scan so you can see what that looks like. So once I've turned that on, my communication app automatically starts scanning through the choices. I haven't had to touch this switch at all yet. So in order for me to speak the word that I want, I need to wait until it gets to the item I want and then hit my switch. Switch, wait for it to get to the word I want. And then it's going to say my word out loud. So you can see I had to have pretty good timing and wait for it to scan to the item that I want before I hit my switch. And again, you can adjust that to make it faster and easier to use. But let's see what we can do if we add a second switch. So I'm going to go back into my settings and I'm going to go to my access method again. And instead of one switch auto scan, I'm going to use two switch step scan. And so what two switch step scan does is now I can use two switches and I have a lot more control over what happens on my communication device if I can use two switches. So I can use one switch to step through my options. So you can see that is stepping through all my communication options. And the second switch will be my selection. So now I'm going to move down my rows. And select. So if I can use two switches, I have a lot more control over what's happening on my switch screen. You can see this required being able to hit the switches repeatedly and quickly for me to be able to move through all of my options. So that's an example of how you can use switches to control a communication app.
This device, along with a wide variety of other devices, is available to borrow free from Montec. Please visit Montec website for more details. http://montec.ruralinstitute.umt.edu